esta noche en Noticiero Northwestern. En un reportaje exclusivo que solo verá en Noticiero Northwestern, grupos de estudiantes minoritarios cuestionan qué tan inclusivo es Dance Marathon. Le tenemos ambos lados de esta controversia. ¿Qué tal a todos y muy buenas noches? Les saluda Isabela Gutiérrez.
Y yo soy Valeria Rosero. Gracias por acompañarnos.
Sigue la tradición en Northwestern de WAMU. Les diremos lo que separa el show de este año de producciones pasadas.
¿Qué nos podemos dejar el abrigo estos próximos días?
Así es. Valeria, ¿te imaginas escribir una obra musical completa a nuestra edad? Bueno, eso es exactamente lo que un grupo de estudiantes hace cada año para una producción llamada WAMU. Me senté con varios de los estudiantes involucrados, quienes me contaron sobre el show y lo que significa ser parte de esta tradición. Es Shakespeare como nunca lo había visto, con rutinas de baile, líos amorosos y un sabor a Hollywood. Este fin de semana comenzó la producción número 83 de WAMU en Northwestern. Titulado Double Feature Hollywood and Vine, el show es una adaptación de la comedia shakespeariana Twelfth Night o Noche de Reyes. Y yo soy Isabela Gutiérrez. Que tengan muy buenas noches.
Go to your rooms, pick up your stuff.
It's Wednesday afternoon, and like any other day of the week, students rush into Centro Romero right after school. Educational coordinator of the youth program, Lisa de Santiago, prepares the day's lessons with volunteer tutors.
For us, really, it's teaching the kids how to grow their brain. Take what they're learning and learn how to apply it. We don't mind mistakes, but not trying, that's not accepted here.
Lisa believes that the program's efforts are more important now than ever, given Chicago's shifting job market.
Mexican families, Puerto Rican families that were from Chicago a generation back, their moms and dads could raise their kids with union factory jobs, the warehouse jobs, but those jobs have left.
Recently, Lisa has seen that parents are becoming more involved in their children's activities and take-home assignments.
They're ready to have their kids be more educated because they don't see another alternative.
Lisa's hope for the kids she works with is that they will use education as a tool to make a difference in the world.
I want my kids to come back to Centro Romero as a sponsor, as a member of the board, as somebody who wants to give back to the community.
31-year-old Susana Salgado, who first came to Centro in seventh grade, is doing just that as the manager of the youth program. She says that she owes all of her success to Centro Romero.
Centro Romero for me was a place where I felt important. It made a difference in my life.
It made so much of a difference that Susana was the first in her family to graduate high school and college.
A lot of my friends that I used to hang out before, they're not in a very healthy environment. If Centro Romero was not there for me, I might have been with them.
But Susie's story is only one of many Centro Romero success stories. All four daughters of Mexican native Maria Duran have been enrolled in the youth program. Her eldest just completed her first year at Northeastern University in Boston. It's all thanks to the homework help at Centro Romero that her grades were so good. Centro Romero's adult program has also helped Maria obtain her GED. I think I don't have words to express what Centro Romero has given to me and my family. From Medill, I'm Isabella Gutierrez.